Welcome to the fastest review in the world. In order to compete with the other talented content creators out there, I have to rely on brutal honesty and brevity. So with that in mind, to answer the question, should I play Tower of Fantasy? The answer is no. That's it. Thank you for stopping by if that's all you wanted. But if you'd like to see why I came up with this conclusion, then please continue watching the video. Hello everyone, my name is Bundiff, and I know what you're thinking. Why should I listen to this bald idiot's opinion on video games? Before you jump to conclusions, I am, of course, talking about me. Again, for the sake of brevity, I can't sit here and list my credentials, but I have had experience with every single MMORPG under the sun. My DMs are open. You can comment on this video. You can contact me anywhere and ask me anything to prove that I know what I know about MMOs. But just to give you an idea, I beta tested for Ultima Online. I am ancient. Alright, so let's begin with the basics. Character creation. The character creation is really in-depth. And I mean really in-depth. You can create virtually almost any anime character you've ever seen in this character creator, but I do have my gripes with it.
I really hate how, like, the females in this game have, like, 8 different customizable options. Meanwhile, the male characters have, like, 3. Okay, so do you want medium length hair, medium to long length hair, short hair, or medium to short length hair? And then, like, with girls, there's, like, 7 different pages of options and 2 different boob sliders.
I know, man. There isn't even a bald option. So, of course, I had to settle for this shit show. Game feel. The combat doesn't actually feel bad at all. For what it is, and forgive the comparison to Genshin, the combat and character movement is responsive and interesting, save for when you enter a laggy channel or for a certain bug that I'll touch on a bit later. I actually enjoyed the combat. For real. I like that I can play as my own idiot custom character instead of being forced to play as this big booba waifu and husbando you get in the polls. Instead, you play with their weapons, and you can equip up to 3 different ones at a time, which makes for a very interesting combat experience. The narrative. I'm not gonna lie, I skipped every single cutscene I could. Don't look at me like that. Pay to win. Of course, no review of this game would be complete without mentioning the obvious and blatant predatory nature of gacha games. I'm not gonna dive into this. I'm just gonna naturally assume that you guys know what you're getting into if you're interested in this game. I will say, however, that this game feels more generous to free-to-play players than at least Genshin Impact. Not sorry. But this isn't what will make or break an MMORPG. Let's be real. The real enemy of games, of any game, of course, say it with me now, longevity. This game, in my expert opinion, yes, does have more longevity than, for example, Genshin Impact, simply by the nature that it is an online game. And of course, an online community can and will generate content for itself. That's why RP players get more of their money's worth than other players when it comes to games like World of Warcraft or Final Fantasy XIV. However, there is next to nothing to do at endgame, no variety. Once you've reached a certain stage in the game, you've seen it all, which, to be fair, isn't rare for an MMORPG, but why am I logging into Tower of Fantasy every day? For what purpose? For PvP? The PvP in this game is a joke! The meta is to use Coco, Name, and Zero to float around the arena and whittle your opponent down with turrets and win the match by letting the timer run out and ending up with more HP because of your obnoxious heals. And that's if you don't get any hackers. Which brings me to another point. The game is riddled with hackers and bugs and exploits. This hacker over here on our server has been destroying the rankings for days. He still holds the highest ranking achievement points. He is using a level 60 suppressor that you can't even unlock because the game has a time gate and he's level 20. Here's a cute little climbing bug you can abuse to never run out of stamina. And here is a nice bug you can abuse with the lightning dagger guy to do insane damage for free. Wow, And lastly, the game, again, is time-gated. You can only reach a certain level every day until they increase the level cap, which honestly wouldn't be so bad because it prevents the sweaties from reaching max level day one. However, they also time-gate your activities. If you're familiar with games like Arc Age, they have this energy system that requires you to spend energy to perform certain activities, such as, but not limited to, going into a fucking dungeon. Like I said before, I was really impressed with the combat. I remember reaching level 20 thinking, wow, this is a lot of fun. I can't wait to use three weapons instead of two. The third weapon slot is locked behind a main story quest, and I kept spamming this quest line in order to get it unlocked. Until my viewers told me during my stream, twitch.tv/bondev, that I was supposed to get it at level 10. Turns out that this is a known bug, and it has been around since launch. I had been playing this whole time with like over 25% of my character just plain missing, effectively making competitive play impossible. I can't compete with these three weapon people, let alone the whales. With all these bugs and exploits and hackers, the devs really don't seem to care much about the quality of their game, but the quantity of their players. And that's it. There is a lot more, but then the format of this video would be too long. So thank you so much for your time. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please consider watching more of my shit and subscribing and follow me on Twitch, please. I beg you. Oh my God. Goodbye.